Many people in their salt shaker put some rice in order to keep the moist from the salt. And therefore, when they use the salt shaker, the rice stays in the salt shaker and the salt comes out. Is that borer? And even more so, it's borer bekli. You're holding back the rice with that shaker. Is that mutar or asur? Machloket. Shomu Zalman Orbach didn't permit such a thing because of the reason we just said. You're using a keli to be borer, to take out the salt and leave the rice, and using a keli for that is not permitted. But Chacham Avadia and many, many other poskim permitted it because there's two things here. First of all, it's not a kli that's meant for brira, unlike those that sifters that not permitted to use, because that's a kli that's made to be borer. But the salt shaker is meant for the salt to come out. If you decided to put some rice in there in order to keep out the moist, so then that doesn't make it a kli that's meant special for brira. And secondly, although you're not allowed to do that, even a kli that's not brira, but there's a second reason to permit over here, and that is you're not really meaning, when you use the salt shaker, you don't mean that to be borer. Rather, you just want the salt to spread around your food. And happen to be, there's also rice over there that stays behind. But that's not your intention right now when you're using the salt shaker, that you want to separate the rice from the salt, and that's the reason it will be permitted. Rav Shlomo Zalman says that no, since you are using the salt shaker and there's rice over there, really you have two intentions. One is that the salt should be spread, and secondly, that the rice should stay behind. Chacham Avadia permitted, and Rav Shlomo Zalman said that it's a soul.